Hello everybody and welcome to my channel. My name is Peace. I'm with the Footsteps to Peace. I'm a psychic astrologer and an intuitive life coach. If you are interested in a personal reading, please feel free to check the description box down below. There you'll find the link to my website, thefootstepstopeace.com. Also, like, share, and subscribe. You know I appreciate it. Hit that notification bell so you can be updated the next time I post a video. All right, you guys, so for June 2nd, we got Imagine again. I think we got this one on, what was it, Friday? I don't even remember. I've been doing so many damn readings. Okay. So we got Imagine again, and it's like imagining what your life could be, imagining where you could go, imagine, you know, just use your imagination, be a kid again. I feel like, you know, all in all, it's like if you can dream it and you can believe it, you can receive it. So the card number is the number 20. So this is about, it breaks down into a two. Two is about choices and decisions. It's about, you know, partnerships, all types of things. So turning your imagination into manifestation, creative thought, visualization, the power of aligning imagery and feelings, creativity and illusions. Who do you want to be? What do you need to believe in order to have the life that you want? You were gifted with the power to imagine. If you can dream it, you can create it. This is the time when your imagination is the key to manifesting the life you desire. Spend time daydreaming, fashioning a vision board to help you see your goals, or meditating. Allow the power of your creativity to deliver images of what feeds your soul. Then allow your feelings to mingle with your inspirations and imagine these things being real right now. Then repeat. What you imagine will become your belief, and soon you will see these things come to pass in the outer world as if by magic. In matters of the heart, it's easy to daydream about another as a means of connecting to that person. While that's romantic, if you want this relationship to be real, you need to go for it, not just dream about it. Now is the time to move beyond the daydream and into reality, beyond illusion and into fruition. Relationships are about relating, so step out on the dance floor where imagination partners with manifestation. The message of this card is that a person with attributes you have imagined will enter your life. You'll be changed for the better. Imagine that. Prosperity message says this is a powerful time to get clear on how you create your prosperity, what it means to you to be prosperous, and what attributes you need to develop in your own self so that you can make things happen. Who do you need to be to live out your dreams? Can you imagine the kind of life you desire? Really imagine it? Without holding back the sheer force of your powers of creativity? If you can envision it, you can have it. Get ready, for prosperity is waiting for you to claim it now. Act as if your dreams really will come true, okay? So I always tell people, you know, act as if you're in that relationship. Act as if you already work at that job. Act as if, you know, you already own that house. Act as if you already have that amount in your bank account. Act as if, and acting as if puts you in the vibration so that it can come to you even faster. So keep that in mind, you guys. All right, so Spirit, please show me for June 2nd. June 2nd. Spirit, please show me June 2nd. You know, people always, you know, they want to be happy, but you have to act as if you're already happy. You know, and you actually have to truly be happy in order to be happy. You can't wait until someone else makes you happy in order for that to become a reality. That's just not how it works. It's like you actually have to embody exactly what it is that you're asking the universe for. And in doing so, then all of a sudden, the universe will send you things to be happy about, you know, but you have to, it first comes from you. June 2nd, Spirit, please show me June 2nd for the collective. All right, Five of Wands. So for some of you, this is on-the-job training. For others of you, this is some type of conflict, but I want to stick with the on-the-job training. We do have the Eight of Wands. So I want to say that the challenge is some type of communication, although I want to say that that did show up in the reverse. For some of you, maybe you're conflicted because you're somebody you want to talk to, but there's no communication back and forth right now. This person isn't calling or, you know, trying to make an effort. Now, there it is. There's the apology. Hey, how are you? You know, reaching out. And maybe that can cause some type of conflict. Maybe there is an apology here, or someone also reaching out, you know, to see how you're doing and giving you a cup of love. Nine of Pentacles, for those of you single out there, you know, and I do see the birds, so that is also about communications. Nine of Pentacles is having everything that you need, okay? Six of Wands, this is victory and success. This is public recognition. This is you victoriously overcoming. Lots of wands here, you guys, lots of passion. All right, next card out, look at that. We've got the Knight of Wands showing up. We've got the Two of Wands, which is, you know, going to have to sacrifice certain things in order to move forward. Spirit, please show me. It's like somebody here wanting to offer you the world. King of Pentacles. Somebody who's grounded. Also, this is you, you know, when it comes to your manifestations. Seven of Cups. Choices and decisions that need to be made. Maybe some confusion. Maybe too many options. Maybe too many options in love. And the Ten of Wands. Any other card, Spirit, on that Ten of Wands? So, yep, we've got the King of Cups. We've got the Ace of Swords. And that's it. Bottom of the deck, Ace of Wands. Woo, gosh. All right. So look at this, you guys. So with that said, I feel like, you know, Five of Wands here is all about some type of conflict that you're trying to overcome. And I do believe that mentally you do overcome this. I feel like, you know, there's some decisions that need to be made. Maybe someone here lives at a distance from you and you're trying to decide on whether or not you want to reach out to this person. I feel like someone here wants to offer you the world, but I genuinely feel like they're trying to take a very grounded and slow approach. Slow and steady wins the race, but I do feel like there's, oh my God, right underneath the Ace of Wands is the Ace of Pentacles. So this is like prosperity. This is opportunities for brand new jobs. This is, you know, a passionate new beginning. For a lot of you, this has a lot to do with your business. I feel like, you know, your business is very important. I do feel like, you know, it's starting a new business, starting a new job. Like I said, I feel like this is on the job training. I feel like the money is going to come in. I feel like it's trickling in, you know, and I feel like it's at a very grounded, steady pace. And it's like, you know, coming in, you know, imagine that you already have enough and so it shall be. I feel like somebody here is willing to invest, okay? Somebody here is willing to invest in whatever it is that you're selling. And maybe this person lives at a distance from you, okay? For others of you, I'm going to be honest with you. I see this as business. I see this as work. For others of you, I feel like there's some type of a heavy burden that it's time for you to put down. You know, I look at this. We go from the Two of Wands. We've got the Five of Wands. We've got the, the Ace of Wands, the Two of Wands, the Five of Wands, the Six of Wands, the Eight of Wands, and the outgoing card is the Ten of Wands. So it's like where you're putting down a heavy burden, where you've been trying to carry it all yourself. I feel like, you know, for some of you, this is arrows of love that are going to be coming in. Maybe they're a little stalled out because somebody's trying to make a decision, maybe between a couple of different people. Maybe this person has a few different options. So if this is a love thing, make sure that it's not just a sexual thing and it's something that is grounded. Because yeah, there could be a lot of passion between you and another person, and this person could be offering up a passionate brand new beginning. But at the same time, there has to be some type of stability in this. And I feel like with the King of Pentacles here, if this is a love reading, this is grounded. This is something that's going to last the test of time. They're going to make sure that they're going to get their return on their investment. This person is not willing to settle or, you know, just, it's not the fly by the seat of your pants type of relationship for those of you. And maybe that's a lot of conflict here. But someone here, I do feel like there's something here about public recognition. Wanting to be recognized. I feel like, you know, for some of you, you are being recognized by your peers around you. For others of you, this is like celebrity status. Pay attention to your dreams too. The Knight of Pentacles here is, again, slow and steady wins the race. You know, it's looking out upon the horizon and trying to decide on what it is that you want to invest your time, your energy, your effort, your money, your health, your wealth, all of those things. Where do you want to invest your time? Because the King of Pentacles, he's a wise investor. Okay. The Nine of Pentacles says you have enough to invest. What are you investing in? Some type of clarity is going to be coming in today. Okay. I think that there's a King of Cups here, so I don't know if this is the same person as the King of Pentacles. Could be two totally different people. If it's the same person, this person is very grounded and stable. And for some of you, this person has been keeping their emotions to themselves. But it's like they're wanting to reach out and say something to you. And maybe it could start off something small, and then it grows into something even bigger. Or for some of you, you know, maybe you're dealing with your children today and there's some type of, you know, there's some type of conflict between your children. And I feel like you need to take a softer approach with them. There is some type of communication that could be coming in. And I feel like the communication for some of you, communication's tough. But we are in Gemini season. So it's like, you know, we have to learn different ways of communicating. You know, maybe for some of you, you like to text message, emails, you know, but this needs to be, you know, there's phone calls and stuff here too. So with it being a Gemini, you know, season. Yeah, I do feel like somebody here lives at a distance. I feel like you're having to turn your back on drama. And I think that because you turned your back on drama, justice has been served. And it's like you're moving away. You know, it's like, you know, there's a lot of passion here. And this is you taking back your power. I see the red cloak here. I see his red cloak here. Okay. And then I see the red here and the red here. And this is where you take back your power. For some of you, you could either be, well, I don't see. And, you know, the best part about this reading today is, the only major arcana is a clarifier card in this reading. And that's the Justice card. So for some of you, you're dealing with a Libra. Maybe for some of you, you're hoping a Libra will come back. You're waiting on a Libra. But this is a decision. Or maybe this Libra is making a decision. What I like about today's reading is the fact that this is a free will reading. There's nothing here. There's no major life lessons. There's nothing here that is like, you know, really standing in the way of anything except for our thoughts, you know? And it's like, okay, what are we passionate about? What do we want to build? Maybe for some of you, it's like you want to build something, but you don't really have a plan. And that's okay. Get started anyway. You know, sometimes that's all you got to do is just get started. And all of the, you know, the plan ends up working itself out. It's like when I started my business 6 years ago, you know, it was like, I didn't have a plan. I just had a, you know, book of tarot or, you know, box of tarot. And next thing you know, it's like I'm building this empire and it's freaking amazing. So you never know, but imagine it. If you believe in it, you can receive it. If you believe in this relationship, you can receive it. If you believe in this job, you can receive it. And I feel like it's going to bring a lot of clarity. Somebody here is going to want to clarify their feelings for you. Trust. This situation is calling for you to have faith. You've got to trust in this divine plan. And your good karma is going to play out. Children are a factor in your love life right now. So again, there's that Page of Cups. So for some of you, you know, it's like the kids, maybe you're spending too much time, or maybe for some of you, you know, you're acting like children. Grow up. Attraction. You attract romantic love by enjoying this moment fully. In the bottom of the deck, express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. Go ahead and reach out and extend that olive branch. Offer up something tangible so that there's an offer of a brand new path. I do feel like there's going to be some type of clarity today. Cupid's arrow is definitely here. Here's Cupid's arrow, and I feel like there's some type of passionate endeavor. For some of you, you're dealing with your kids today. It's the love of your children. If there's someone out there that you have been interested in and you've had your eye on, you know, reach out. Say hello. You know, the answer is always no unless you ask. Although, be mindful that it's not exes and things like that because it is a Mercury in retrograde and we're not trying to go back to the past. We're trying to step up our game, okay? So keep that in mind and, you know, look at this. You know, the Nine of Pentacles is where she's like, she's enjoying the fruits of her labor. She's got everything she needs. She takes time to stop and smell the roses. You know, she's got nice clothes. She takes really good care of herself. You know, she's all about her animals. For some of you, it's like you're working with animals. Maybe, you know, wanting a new animal. For some of you, bringing in a new animal, even if it's a fish. For some of you, it's a horse. Maybe for some of you, you're even going to be asked to go horseback riding. See, the horse is here, you know, with the Six of Wands and the Knight of Pentacles. And then I see the animals here. And I see the little snail here. So I did say slow and steady wins the race. But it's time to spread your wings and fly. Yeah, the King of Pentacles definitely wants, you know, I feel like the King of Pentacles, he definitely wants a commitment. But he's in this place of limbo right now because he's been hurt. For others of you, be careful of hurting your back today, okay? Be mindful of back issues. But it's time to end that cycle. It's time for you to see things from a different perspective. It's like the King of Pentacles, he's got everything, but the one thing that he doesn't have is love, you know? So if you're in this place where you don't have love, it's like you can have all the money in the world, but do you have love, you know? So keep that in mind. Anyway, you guys, I want to thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys have a wonderful Wednesday. And we will chat again soon. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. You know I appreciate it. Take care.